So, as far as history is concerned, this would be interactive. So you're free to ask me the question, but please do raise hand so I do know if you have any question. As far as history of this place is concerned, I need to give a brief introduction to our history. Our history starts from Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wa salam. Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wa salam passed away. He was martyred in 148th of Hijra calendar, which is 765 of Common Era. He had many sons. One of the sons was Ismail, and the other being Imam Kadhim alayhi salatu wa salam, other being Abdullah Dibaj. The Shia, who were afterwards going to become Ithna Ashari, they followed Imam Kadhim alayhi salatu wa salam, but Ismailis, they followed Ismail. After Ismail, Muhammad al-Ismail was Imam, as the Ismaili Imam. We believed in Imam Radha alayhi salatu wasalam. We take pride in believing in Imam Radha alayhi salatu wasalam. But Ismailis, they started believing in Muhammad, son of Ismail. And there were three other Imams after Muhammad: Ahmad al-Wafi, Muhammad al-Taqi, and Abdullah al-Radi. These three were hidden Imams for Ismailis. Then there was a person named Ubaidullah al-Mahdi. He went all the way from Medina, Yemen, and then he went to Syria, and from there he went to North Africa. In North Africa, they established a government which was named Fatimid government. A very rich government, an empire in North Africa, Tunisia, Algeria, Kairouan, and many other places. I'm doing my thesis on that region, North Africa. Ubaidullah al-Mahdi, till one of the Imam, whose name was Mustansir. Mustansir had two sons, Nizar and Musta'ali. Bohoras, they believe in Musta'ali as their Imam. Aga Khani, they believe in Nizar as their Imam. The split between Bohoras and Aga Khani is coming from the 19th Imam. Till Nizar, they were okay, both of them. But then there was a split. What happened with the Nizari movement, they went to, from North Africa and Egypt, they went to Iran. In Iran, once again, some of the Imams were able to, I'm not discussing about Musta'ali and the Bohra tradition, I would just jump into the Nizari movement, which was Aga Khani movement. From North Africa, they are traveling to Iran. In Iran, they had empire. Alamut still in Qazvin is a rich fort. Kahak, Anjodan, and many other places, they have that trace in Alamut and Iran. When they were in Iran, the Imams were used to send many people and preachers for the sake of disseminating and spreading the message of Ismaili Aga Khani thing, right? The word Aga Khani I'm using is just for the sake of, we do understand, there was no Aga Khan at that time. They were proper Nizari Ismaili people. So Iran, they were sending many people in different parts of the world. Some of them, preachers, came to India to preach the message of Nizari movement. One of the preacher, his name was Peer Sadruddin. When Peer Sadruddin came to this part of the, like that India in those days, and we are now discussing about an era approximately 600 years ago. So those da'is and those missionaries and those preachers, they came to India in the region of Sindh, which is Karachi in Pakistan, and Kutch and Buch, which would be traveling, and then Kathiawad, and then later on Mumbai. Yeah. So these preachers, they were preaching the message of Nizari Ismailis. Inshallah ta'ala, throughout the course, we would be discussing what sort of preaching they were doing. And in Bhuj, we would be visiting the shrine of Pir Ghulam Ali Shah, who was one of the preachers, right? And their contribution to bring the movement of Nizari Ismaili tradition in India, that day's India. So they converted Hindus into Muslims. Which Muslims? Sunni or Shia? Shia Muslims. Which Shia Muslims? Nizari Ismaili Muslims, not the Isnashini tradition. So some of our forefathers decided to join the movement, saying like, you know, this is a good preaching. And they joined the movement and they became from Hindu to Muslims, Muslims, Shia Muslims, and so on and so forth. What happened is there were young communities. So they had their Hindu tradition. They were preserving their Hindu tradition. But the rasam rivaj, khavanu pivanu, badu kevu hatu, Hindu jevu. Nam, once again Hindu. Just the ideological belief, not to the extent which we have in, you know, in our communities nowadays. Very basic thing. Betran vasu, dafan kya karo kabrasan ma, have aapne Hindu ni jem nathi karo. Nikah, Musalman ni jem. Namaz padta tha, we are not sure. They were praying, we don't have any historical records showing that. Nikah ni ceremony, nikah padi naksu Arabic ma je mulla karavi dise. Par badu biju badu, apde apde jem karvano. Lu gau nu ne, agar batti ne, I badu apde karsu. They were able to mix both the traditions. More of a Hindu, less of a Muslim. That was the community, and that is how people live in India. Yeah, if we still go in the village, they have a hodgepodge. It's a wrong question to ask a person in India to which religion you belong. Because religion is a concept which was introduced by Western colonies. Ilokona ava olataki religion. In Hinduism, they don't have religion, they have tradition. They have customs. They have rituals. And for that reason, they have multi-million gods. Every community, they have their internal thing to celebrate. Not as a one unified religion. Fine? So that was first part of my discussion. Second part of my discussion with you. Now when we have understood the movement, we have understood about the India, let's discuss the major events which is now changing India. Please, Ashik bhai.
I was just wondering, jare aalo kaiva tha, jare we were originally Hindus by Mahayana tradition.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Some of us. There would be a lecture, inshallah ta'ala, at some another occasion where I would be discussing ke apna badani surname je che thodik alag che. Thodak lok apna mati eni surname ni aavshe. Rajani, Bhimani, Burani, bolo. Non G, ni. Burani, Virani,
Sayani,
Dhirani, Damani. So they were one tribe. પછી આપણામાંથી જી વાળા છે રામજી લાલજી શિવજી બરાબર છે અનધર તો ટુ સે કે આપણે એક જ બધા હતા દેટ્સ વી નીડ ટુ યુ નો હેવ દેટ અસમ્પશન ક્લિયર વી વુડ ડીલ વિથ ધીસ ઇશ્યુ થેન્ક યુ ફોર બ્રિંગિંગ ધીસ આઈ વુડ બી કવરિંગ દેટ ઇન્શાલ્લાહ એટ લેટર સ્ટેજ સો નાવ વી હેવ કવર્ડ એઝ એન ઇન્ટ્રોડક્શન શું થઈ રહ્યું હતું નાવ દેર આર થ્રી થિંગ્સ વિચ આઈ વુડ લાઈક યુ ટુ મેક એ નોટ ઓફ ઇટ which is going to change India entirely as far as our Khoja tradition is concerned. Three banao, three kissa, three instances. Number one, British Raj was founded in 1858. British hata aya India ma pehla pan, they were running under East India Company. But as a British Raj, 1858 ni andar shu thyu, British, they said like, you know, we now want to introduce રિલિજિયસ બધું હવે ડાયસેક્ટ કરી નાખીએ તમને ખબર છે બ્રિટિશ લોકોને કેટલો શોખ હોય છે કેટેલોગ કરવાનું સર્વે કરવાનું યુ નો દે હેવ ધીસ થિંગ્સ યા સો દે સ્ટાર્ટેડ ડુઈંગ સર્વે which is a good thing, but it works in West, it doesn't work in large India, because India doesn't work as a unified country, especially during those days. Christianity, Islam is a unified religion. But Hinduism ni andar em no hoy ki apne bada Hindu chhe, atle tamara belief shu chhe, that's a wrong question to ask, because belief is not the central idea of Hinduism. Barabar, but British no assumption wrong hato. 1858, survey kariye, we dissect the people, aloko Hindu, a Musliman, aam chhe. Well, they wanted each and everyone to identify themselves as being in which religion do you believe? And tamne kevu padse? Tab em kesho ke na, well, I'm not sure, amaram thoduk em nahi. Decide karo, Hindu cho ke Musliman cho ke Christian cho ke Sikh cho. Karan ke amne lakhu chhe. For the sake of unifying, they slaughtered the spirit of, you know, a diversity in the Indian community.
Please. I think the British policy was also to create this religious thing, was to create internal conflict with them so they could rule.
That's a conspiracy theory.
Yeah, but in the
divide and rule. Divide and rule.
Fine, definitely. And British are smart enough to confess this thing as well. I would recommend you to read Shashi Tharoor's Inglorious Empire, wonderful book, and you could read all these things in that particular book. So that's the first instant. Okay, India changed to 1858, and that they wanted to, you know, dissect the community. That's the first thing. Number two, dissenting voices. I told you that three instances changed in India in 1850s, and that you 19th century. The second was so dissenting voices. Jilo ko Hindu mati Musliman nizari thya tha, now they are now, you know, learned people in British India. They started raising voice against the establishment, Nizari Ismaili establishment. Je Ismaili Imam Iran ma hata, ilo ko no relation to Khoja saate, je ahiya hata. India ma Nizari Ismaili je bani gaya tha. So now, Imam was asking to send him the religious taxes. And tumne khabar chhe, Khoja paase thi koi time lehi shakar, pa paisa no lehi shakar. So have je chhe now, they were asking money and there was no accountability, transparency, other issues. So some of the Khojas in 1829, they started raising their voices. Ke abadu paisa kem, kya, shu, kevi rite, property kona name chhe. Imams were in Iran. There were some people over here who were in touch, so transparency was an issue. You know how we conduct our organizations, exco and a conference, we take accounts, right? So same 1829, they were taking accounts and things were not clear. They started raising their voices against the establishment. We don't believe because like you people are taking money and like, you know, we don't know where it's going and like, you know, how you're operating and who is the imam and all this stuff. 1829 ni andar imam ismaili na betha tha iran ni andar ye ena relatives ne mokliya ahiya badu samjhava mate, but things were not working well. That was in 1820. That's second thing why things were changing. Number 3, Aga Khan's arrival. Aga Khan is one of the imams in the line of Nizari Ismaili, a fourth Aga Khan che. I'm talking about the first Aga Khan. So first Aga Khan, he arrived in India in 1846. First Aga Khan, in issues of the Iran ni andar, Qaja dynasty sa te jagdo hato, then he went from there to Afghanistan. He was very close to British. British ye ene gana bada paisa pension api di dudu. Kanke he helped British in Afghanistan to establish the ruling. Kanke language same Afghanistan ma Irani Farsi ane Farsi avde atle beine jami gyu ane British said like, would you be able to conquer some of our lands because you have troops, you have language, you know the tradition, people believe in you. So yeah, I can do this favor. They didn't ke British ke do, I can do favor for you, tamne 20,000 rupees pension tarike aapu chu. Then again in Karachi Aga Khan help kari British ne. So they had very close ties before he arrived in India. 1846 ni andar he ultimately came here. Iranis were not happy he coming over here. And ikich mane pachu jau chu. Irani kidu ame nahi aava deshu unless he revolt kai no kare. And he was of that person ke ne revolt karvo tu. So that's the third instance. Okay, so things got fishy, things got changing. Fine. Amaru second part of my conversation. Introduction kidu me, pachi tamne kidu ke there are three instances which is changing India. Yeah. So now how India is changing due to these three things. Dissenting voices are the people who were sort of not happy with the establishment, especially Aga Khan is coming over here. People are not happy with him as well, because the people, like he was sitting in Iran, people were thinking Imam is a pious person, Imam is like, and he's like, you know, he's living a lavish life. This is not how Imam is supposed to live. We heard many stories of Imam Ali, like, you know, in a very humble life. And he is like, you know, he's not living a humble life. How could he be Imam? How could he be Imam in the same way Imam Ali used to be as an Imam? Fine. So, what should we do? They said, let's separate from the major jamaat. Because the major jamaat ne aaj badu karvo to. Je tamari jeva loko hata, tofani, including mara pardadao, e loko ishu karu, we won't be able to be with them. We should raise our voice because it's injustice for the sake of truth, for the sake of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salatu wasalam, we need to speak the truth. So we need some mullahs, right? We need some preacher who can guide us, because now we are like raising our voice against the establishment. Tyare Mullah Kader Hussain JV Hasti apne help karije. Can we allow salawat on the honor of Mullah Kader? So Mullah Kader jeva loko hata e aiva ane apanne navo mazhab ane navo din je che e apanne sikhvadyu. Mullah Kader, this great personality, when he was 18 years old, he arrived in Mumbai. Hu tamne enathi pehla thoduk samjavu to tamne khyal avshe ke what is transpiring in those days. 1814 ni andar Zanzibar became the capital for Ummani Sultan Sayyid Said. 1814 ni andar. 1844 ni andar Mullah Kader was born in India, in Madras. Madras, nowadays they call it Chennai, which is south of India. Right? So Mullah Kader, he was born in 1844. When he was 18 years old, he left Madras for Mumbai. In Mumbai aiva. Shukam aiva? To preach the religion. To teach young people kona. He had no idea of like Khojas and everything. But when he came here, he started running a madrasa. He started asking people to come to him. So, bache ne Quran sikhwadi sake. What happened, like Khojas in Mumbai, apne kidu tran instance thai gaya ne dissenting voices, they were not happy with the mainstream establishment. So they were looking for some people who could guide them. So Mullah Kader jare ahi aaya to kidu he is a good person, yeah, he is teaching Quran, why not we ask our kids to go to this madrasa and learn Quran. The concept of madrasa started before the concept of masjid. Why? Because masjid, you go for your own purpose, right? Danda ma kamani thai, dollars made, pounds made. But madrasa ma pounds deva pade. Right? We started with madrasa because knowledge comes first, then comes ibadat. So, those khojas, tamara, bab dada, obada, iloko ikido apre madrasa ma jaye. Kona Mullah Kader. Mullah Kader, in the madrasa, he started teaching Quran. He was just 18 years old. I'm not saying he was topmost learned alim, normal, ek sara manas. Yeah, he. But in those days, he thoda time mate jaiya aata. He was born in Madras, he came to Mumbai. Mumbai thi pacha Madras kya, because he felt ke aji etlu sikhya nathi, he was like naive, right? 18 years old. Jawan, youth, he went to Madras back. Kido, I need to go to learn my religion to Karbala. He travels all the way Karbala. કરબલામાં એ તાલીમ હાસિલ કરે છે. હી ઇઝ અંડર ધ સુપરવિઝન ઓફ આયતુલ્લાહ ઝૈનુલ આબિદીન માઝંદરાની. આયતુલ્લાહ ઝૈન, આપણે કરબલામાં હરમમાં જઈએ ને તો એક ગેટમાં જઈએ તો એના લેફ્ટ હેન્ડ સાઈડ ઉપર આયતુલ્લાહ ઝૈનુલ આબિદીન માઝંદરાનીની કબર છે. I would like you to visit that place whenever you go next time to Karbala. Let's raise our hands. May Allah give us tawfiq to visit the shrine of Imam Hussein alayhi salatu wa sallam. Can I allow salawat in the honor of Imam Hussein alayhi salatu wa sallam? So he went to Karbala. Ayatollah Zainul Abid Mazi, he studied there. When he was there was a group of people from different parts of India visiting Karbala for ziyarat. Nur Muhammad Meghji, he visited Karbala for the ziyarat. When he visited Karbala for the ziyarat, he met Mullah Qadar. Olkhana tene karan ki he was in Mumbai at that time. So they met Mullah Qadar, and Mullah Qadar, they met Ayatollah Zainul Abidin Mazandarani as well. Second person whom met Mullah Qadar was Hashim Bhai Dosa Bhai and Ghulam Muhammad Hashim. They met Mullah Qadar in Karbala as well to discuss about Khoja and Aam. And the third person whom met is Devji Bhai Jamal. So Atrani Mullah Qadar ne made che. They were discussing with Mullah Qadar. Kisi look, our community is like a naive community. We don't know anything. We want to learn from you. You please do come. Ne abadi vasu. Tya local Karbalani, and there was a person named Shujat Bakshi. He recommended to this group ke why not you take Mullah Qadar back to Mumbai ne Zanzibar and you could teach them. And Mullah Qadar could teach the religion to the Khoja people. So Mullah Qadar is like, nah, I want to study this and that. Ayatollah Zainul Abidin Mazandarani said him like, you should go because people are waiting for you. So our first marja is Ayatollah Zainul Abidin Mazandarani. Our first preacher is Mullah Qadar Hussain. E aiva. Kya aiva India ma. So he's coming for the second time in Mumbai. And he is arriving on 1873. He was 29 years old at that time. First 18 years ma aavata, ave pachi tya study karu. Now he is 29 when he is coming. When he came here, he started a movement. Our forefathers joined with him. In terms of bachcha ne madrasa mokle ni va sikva, they were providing financial support. Originally, he was supposed to go Zanzibar. Because in Mumbai, issues were there. Ismailis, Khoja, Zanzibar was a good place for him to go. But he was not able to go Zanzibar. He was here. So our ancestors did two things. Bachchao mate, madreso, pote bada, and support kare. In this support, that person has seen a great deal of pain we won't be able to imagine. To the extent he got a place to rent, the other people would come and they would say he is making division in the Khoja community, he's making other people's like Isnashari Khojas, we would not allow him to leave. Some people were sent to assassinate him. To the extent, some of our forefathers were not supporting him because the issue was the Moti Jamaat people were coming back to them, ki tame ke mane support karo jo. So our forefathers were in dilemma as well, ki ke mane apne bolaya chhe, then we need to respect him. But on the other side, there are issues. So that person has seen so much pain, we even can't imagine, yeah? I would recommend to read the book of memoir of Mullah Qadar. He wrote a book of memoir. I won't take much of your time now. I'm already running 5 minutes late. I would take further 5 minutes because walking distance to Masjid is just like 5 to 7 minutes. But rest of Mullah Qadar's story I'm going to cover in Mughal Masjid. The issue is Mughal Masjid was established in 1860. Now we are discussing the era of 1878. Yeah? અને તમને હવે ટાઈમલાઈન ખબર પડી કે 1840ની અંદર ઝાન્ઝીબાર, આ બધું 1878ની અંદર થાય છે, મુઘલ મસ્જિદ એસ્ટાબ્લિશ 1860 અને મસ્જિદ વોઝ બિલ્ટ ઇન 1900, એટલે 107-8 વર્ષ થયા છે આના. વાય વી આર હિયર, વાય વી સિલેક્ટેડ ધીસ ફર્સ્ટ પ્લેસ એન્ડ વાય મોહમ્મદ અલી બંદેલી ભાઈ ઇઝ ટેકિંગ ઓનર ઓફ લાઈક યુ નો બિંગ એ મેનેજિંગ ટ્રસ્ટી ઓફ ધીસ પ્લેસ? બિકોઝ હિયર ધ સ્ટોરી બિગિન્સ. આ મદરેસું હતું કે જેમાં બધા ભણ્યા છે, અહીંયા કુરાન અહીંયા શીખ્યા છે, મિટિંગ્સ અહીંયા થતી હતી, રાઈટ? અને દેન એવરીથિંગ વોઝ વર્ક્સ વેલ ઇન ટર્મ્સ ઓફ લાઈક ધીમે 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 કમ્યુનિટી આ બને છે. ઇન નેક્સ્ટ 30-40 યર્સ, લાઈક 1878થી લઈને જમાત ગેટ્સ એસ્ટાબ્લિશ, ઇટ્સ અ લેન્થી સ્ટોરી, આઈ વુડ ડેફિનેટલી ડૂ, બટ દેટ્સ ઇન મોગલ મસ્જિદ. આઈ વુડ જસ્ટ કવર્ડ બિટ ઓફ ધ લાઈફ ઓફ મુલ્લા કાદર બિકોઝ વી આર હિયર ઇન ધીસ મહેફિલ. I have another 3 minutes for your questions. Yeah, Ashif bhai.
I just want to know, you have given us some history of our Khoja, but we were originally all from Gujarat.
That's right.
We would like to also know that where we were converted into the Ismailis and eventually signed, I live from Gujarat, and how did we migrate into India? We know about our migration from Gujarat to East Africa. So is it that we converted ourselves from Ismaili into Smashbins after the migration of the Gujarat from Gujarat towards Africa and the migration from Gujarat to Mumbai? That part is a very confusing part.
Very critical question, and thank you for bringing this very critical question. There is no straightforward answer one line because it is complicated, because we are here like multiple people over here. So very briefly, I think many people at the back must have not listened to what Ashik bhai said in the question. The question is like, we do know about the Mumbai history and this, we know about East Africa as well, Gujarat as well, but how to interconnect these things? Yeah, so everything was in Gujarat when Pir Sadruddin was, before 600 years ago. There was no Khoja Shia Isnashari and like, you know, in Mumbai at that time. Everything was in Gujarat. From Gujarat, people started coming to Mumbai, Mumbai being a trade center. And a Khoja khabar, jab paisa dekha, it's like magnet, right? People start going for like, you know, going to those places for like economic opportunities. To apde Mumbai aava, thoda klo kaam aati. Anyone who is in Mumbai, if they recall their history, down the line, before 300 years, 200 years, they would end up in one of the places of Gujarat. Let me give you an example. Devji Bhai Jamal, from where he was from Bhavnagar. Yeah? And his business, Mumbai Saman Irite, Zanzibar Ma Irite, at East Africa, Mumbai Ma Retata, and a Bhai Pa Mumbai Ma Retata, but they were from Bhavnagar. So originally, all of us were in Mahua, Bhavnagar, Bhuj, Kera, Mandvi, Mundra, you know, Kathiawad, Kach Bhuj, right? So that part of it. Then for the economical opportunity, some of them migrated to Mumbai and then to East Africa. We have instances who directly migrated from Gujarat straight away to East Africa. They didn't come to Mumbai.
Smiley.
Yeah, no, I'm just for the economical purpose. Now I'm coming second part of your question. What about the religious affiliation? Once again, in Gujarat, everyone was like more Hindu, less Muslims. Yeah, they were calling themselves like, you know, Khojas, but more Hindus, less Muslims. When they migrated to Mumbai, there were parallel movements. So I discuss about Mullah Qadr over here. Simultaneously, we have Abdul Hussein from Madras in Mahua, who is teaching in Mahua Madrasa. Yeah, we have parallel movement going there. And then there were friends and family. જે રીતે હજી આપણે લોકો ટોરન્ટોમાં હોય પણ મંડાજી ને બારાજી ન ભૂલીએ આપણે. શું કામ? કારણ કે દેર આર ધોઝ ક્રોસ કલ્ચરલ રિલેશન્સ, રાઈટ? સેમ વસ્તુ. પીપલ ઇન મુંબઈ, ધ રૂટ્સ આર ઇન ગુજરાત, દે હેવ ધીસ ક્રોસ કનેક્શન્સ. તો રિલિજનની અમારે મુંબઈમાં આમ થાય છે, ફોન કરશે ઈસ્ટ આફ્રિકામાં હું મજલિસ પડતો હોય, આ હા કોમેલભાઈ શું પડ્યા મજલિસની અંદર, ટોરન્ટોમાં પંચાયત કરશે બધા. You know, we have this cross, our network is very wide. So, Mumbai ni andar a revolt tha, સમાચાર ત્યાં પહોંચે, થોડાક દિવસ પછી ત્યાં જે થાય એ અહીંયા પહોંચે. વન્સ અગેન ઇન વન ઓફ ધ પ્લેસ આઈ વુડ લાઈક ટુ ડિસ્કસ એદલજી ધનજી કાબા વેરી ડિટેલ મેનર. અમરેલીમાં શું થતું હતું? અમરેલી વોઝ એસ એ જમાત, બધાએ થોડી થોડી હેલ્પ કરી. મહુવાએ હેલ્પ કરી, ભાવનગરે સોફા આપ્યા એને, મહુવા લોકોએ વાસણ આપ્યા, ગુસલખાનું જે છે ભાવનગર આપ્યા. બિકોઝ વેન એ કમ્યુનિટી ઇઝ ડેવલપિંગ, પીપલ સ્ટાર્ટ ડોનેટિંગ, આ કમ્યુનિટી બની જાય. સો ધીસ ઇઝ હાઉ રિલિજન ઇઝ સ્પ્રેડિંગ. આઈ હેવ એન આન્સર ફુલ્લી ઇન અ નટશેલ, બટ આઈ વિલ કમ બેક ટુ ધીસ ઇન એ પર્ટિક્યુલર લેક્ચર, સેપરેટ લેક્ચર. ઇન નટશેલ, ગુજરાતની અંદર રિલિજન ચેન્જ થાય છે આપણું, મુંબઈનું ત્યાં ટ્રાન્સફર થાય, અહીંયાનું ત્યાં થાય છે. એઝ ફાર એઝ ઇસ્ટ આફ્રિકા ઇઝ કન્સર્ન, દેવે મોર હિન્દુ લેસ મુસ્લિમ્સ, નંબર વન. મોર ડિસેન્ટિંગ વોઇસ લેસ ઇસ્માઇલીઝ વેન દેર રીચ ટુ ઇસ્ટ આફ્રિકા. એટલે ઇસ્ટ આફ્રિકામાં પણ આપણે ઇસ્માઇલી હતા. વેન દે મેટ આયતુલ્લા ઝૈનુલ આબિદ માઝંદાની મુલાકાદર, ધેન થિંગ્સ ચેન્જ. સો 1878ની અંદર મુલાકાદર, દે મેટ હિયર ટુ મુલાકાદર, દે વે ગોઈંગ ટુ દેજીભાઈ જમાલ. એ મુલાકાદર અહીંયા રાખ્યા, પોતે પાછા ઇસ્ટ આફ્રિકા આવી ગયા, ત્યાં પછી મેસેજ લઈને જાય. વી મેટ મુલાકાદર, અવર કિડ્સ આર લર્નિંગ ઇન મદ્રેસા. આયતુલ્લા ઝૈનુલ આબિદ માઝંદાર સેન્ટ ઇજાઝા. Community is growing, people is, the movement is like, you know, strengthening, let's do it, you know. ઈ લોકોને પણ 20 years થયા ઝાંઝીબારમાં to make the most ને મસ્જિદ ને. Yes, sir. Yeah, I had one. Yeah. So, Ismailiti nathi, very good question, once again, brilliant question. The question is, Ismailis were like, you know, they got opportunity, they preach karu to apde thai gaya, and pachi apde U-turn karu, and pachi Imam Kazim alayhi salam paase aaya. Why not straight aavi gaya? That's the question. The answer is, Ismail, Mohammad Ismail, pachi Taqi, Razi ne, je Ismaili Imam hata, ghaibat ni andar ne, kaan ke Ismailis were able to establish a government. And when you have government, you have power, you have money, you have culture, you have tradition, and you have, like, you know, you could spread the message. Apna imamo, they were not able to establish the government. Imam Kazim alayhi salam, Imam Raza alayhi salam, Imam Jawad alayhi salam, apde hatud nahi. Apdu kya re thiyu? Sheikh Tusi na zamana ma. Sheikh Tusi died in 460, Ale Boweni government. At that time, she has nationally spread it. Yeah? Last, I'm going to take this as the last question, yeah?
Sheikh, there is a little bit of a complex here within the period which you have enlightened, about 1844, Muhammad Qadri was born and all this thing. But bear in mind, you see, there the migration to Zanzibar from Gujarat. Because, you see, as far as Zanzibar, Shia Isnashri, the first Jamaat which was established was 1882.
Yeah. Not state avi gaya, that's a question. The answer is, Ismail, Mohammad Ismail, pachi Taqi Razi ne, je Ismaili Imam hata ghaibat ni andar ne, kaan ke Ismailis were able to establish a government. And when you have government, you have power, you have money, you have culture, you have tradition, and you have, like, you know, you could spread the message. Apna imamo, they were not able to establish the government. ઇમામ કાઝિમ અલી સામ, ઇમામ રઝા અલી સામ, ઇમામ જવાદ અલી સામ, આપણે હતું જ નહીં. આપણું ક્યારે થયું? શેખ તુસીના જમાનામાં. શેખ તુસી ડાઇડ ઇન 460, આલે બોવેની ગવર્નમેન્ટ. એટ ધેટ ટાઈમ શી હેઝ નેશનલી સ્પ્રેડ ઇટ. યા, લાસ્ટ, આઈ એમ ગોઈંગ ટુ ટેક ધીસ એઝ અ લાસ્ટ ક્વેશ્ચન. યા,
શેખ, ધેર ઇઝ અ લિટલ બિટ ઓફ અ કોમ્પ્લેક્સ હિયર વિધિન ધ પીરિયડ વિચ યુ હેવ એનલાઇટન, અબાઉટ 1844. Muhammad Qadri was born and all this thing. But bear in mind, you see, there the migration to Zanzibar from Gujarat. Because, you see, as far as Zanzibar, Shia Isnashri, the first Jamaat which was established was 1882.
Yeah.
Now, there must have been a period, where Shia Isnashri, the group, was already established. And then to go and establish a Jamaat in 1882, that means there was a period of a little bit of, lot of discussion within the Khoja Shia.
Yeah, very wonderful question. That's the last question before we leave. The question is, which we are discussing, 1878, And in 1882, Zanzibar Jamaat was established, right? So how this is happening? Very straightforward. Devji Bhai Jamal is the key person between Mumbai and East Africa. So 1878, he is not living in Mumbai. He kept Mulla Khadar over here. He got his information, ke like, you know, Mumbai ni andar a movement sharu che and everything. He got there and he was able to establish everything there. And there was less tension in Zanzibar compared to Mumbai, because here there was a big Jamaat, right? So between 1878 and 1882, 4 years, he did his job. Yeah, and many others as well. Yeah?
Because the supplement one, yeah, is a supplement one, is 1882. That is the first Jamaat of Khoja to be established in the whole world. Mumbai followed after it.
Mumbai established 1901.
Yeah. Now this 1882. Now that means my observation to you, that this group between Ismaili and Islashri must have started long time back there from in Zanzibar to establish a Jamaat, because you need quite a good time.
Yeah, so the issue is, as I mentioned, like, the migration started in 1800s, right? And then we have drought in Gujarat, so people started. Zanzibar being a capital of Sultan, so other people migrated. Economical open, people were migrating. There were still issues in East Africa, like, you know, dispute between Ismailis and, like, you know, the dissenting voices. So people were there. What I'm saying is, the first record of East African Shia Isnashri inclinations, the record which we have is from Devji Jamaat. So people were still going to Karbala before we became Isnasharis.
Agha Khan's book is written, the Agha Khan, in which he showed.
Yeah, so let's take the questions at the end. Firdose Bari, I know what you're recommending, but the issue is, like, let's summarize it. The movement was there from 1800 to, let's say, like, 19, Amreli Jamaat got like 1910, yeah? So in this 110 years, many Jamaats are being established. The first record which we have of Devji Jamal being Isnashari openly is 1878. So we need to figure out which is the first recorded history, right? Not oral history, recorded history. So the first recorded history which we have, 1878. Of Devji Bhai Jamal, and as I mentioned, Devji Bhai Jamal is there. It doesn't mean Devji Bhai Jamal was the first person to make the entire movement. Dissenting voices were there from 1829. No, hold on. From 1829, the dissenting voices. So from 1820, movement was there, but 1878 it clicked. I'm not going to take any questions now. We could do. Yeah. I'm not going to take any questions. We have like 10 minutes to reach to mosque, and inshallah we'll continue our discussion in Mughal Masjid as well. Can we have loud salawat bar Muhammad?